We got a match for you today. Actually, two match, but here is the first one. Aidan Benson versus Cole Sanders. Who will win between the Bombad and the Seltzer? Tune in right now. What is up, everyone? Welcome back to Real Trivia Face Off. My name is Albert. I'm joined by Jacob in today's match. Jacob, we got a great match here today. Who is playing here? I actually forgot who's playing here today, Jacob. Why don't you tell us?
I believe it is Aidan and Cole, if I remember correctly. I'm hoping at least. That'll make me look pretty dumb if I don't remember.
I think you got that right. And yeah, we have a match between Aidan and Cole. Surprisingly, they've never played each other before in singles, and this is the first time.
Okay.
Yeah, which I'm kind of surprised by. He's not supposed to be in the live chat, but this person is. So Cole, if you're backstage, take away from the live chat in case someone drop answers. Okay, I didn't realize that. I just clicked on random live chat that popped up randomly.
Shout out to Sam though. Okay.
Aidan and Cole both have great seasons so far. Cole last year won the tournament, and this year he went all the way till the quarterfinals of the tournament, where he ran into Owen, I believe, and we haven't played since. Aidan had a solid tournament run, going all the way to the semifinals, also losing to Owen. So now they're both here, trying to either, if the winner obviously is going to continue their season, the loser, their single season will be done this year. So thoughts on these matchup?
Yeah, I think with the pressure of their single season possibly being over, I think that's going to have a little bit of a motivation for them in this match. I think it's going to be really good. Each competitor is going to try their hardest. So I'm excited to see, what they can bring to the match. So.
Yeah, absolutely. And also they are in a title picture. So if they win a couple wins will bring them back right to the championship. Mm-hmm. And I guess Aidan never been in a single championship, so he's still gunning for that. But Cole has had that one before last year. So let's see if he's still hungry for that opportunity once again. But yeah, let's just jump into the promos first, starting with Cole Sanders.
Hello. Let's again introduce my seltzer for this. The match we got Raz Cranberry. My apologies. I think they just consolidated the name because it would be too much on the can, but it should be good. The match might be, but we'll have to see. Hi, Aidan.
Hey there. Sorry, due to budget cuts and time constraints, we have to do this together. So make your thoughts.
It happens. It happens. We spent a lot of that. I'm going to crack my can and I'm ready.
Excellent.
That was unexpected.
Yeah, I really hated it because of the budget cuts, but I guess it makes sense. So yeah, not too much there, but I think Cole's ready. He's got his seltzer, his gross LaCroix. So yeah, we'll see how it goes.
We're never getting sponsored by LaCroix now.
I'm sorry. That's why we have budget cuts.
We lost our sponsors. Yeah. You're cutting in and out. The internet's bad. I'm just kidding. You're not cutting in and out. I'm just messing with you. This is gonna be a great match. Let's just jump into the player introductions. Where the hell is that curtain? There it is. There's no music, is there?
No, due to budget cuts, we have no music.
give me one second. Let's cut to the police. All right, I think we're good. Let's try that again. Nothing ever happened. This is not live. We can cut it out. We can cut it out. This is not live.
Right? Oh, okay. Okay, cool. Not live. Okay, I got you.
All right. All right. 3, 2, 1. All right, let's just jump to the introductions. Nothing happens. Let's just jump into it. Dang curse. With a record of 7 wins, 8 defeats, and 3 technical knockouts, he is one half of the Black Sparrows. He is Paul the Seltzer Sanders.
Maybe we're making budget cuts because our producing team can't hold their shit together. Just a thought. Maybe they shouldn't be getting paid so much, just saying. Love you both.
And his opponent, with a record of 7 wins, 7 defeats, with 2 knockouts and 1 technical knockout, he is one half of Name of the Win. It is Aidan the Bombad Benson.
I love lamp. I love lamp.
Aidan just suddenly turned into a fly. Got it. Are you Jeff Goldblum in?
No. Chaos.
What the?
Well, we're not getting LaCroix anymore, that's for sure.
Wants to be sponsorship?
We could get Bubbly, maybe. But maybe we get Bubbly for Lucky Pole. But we're not getting high tier seltzers for sure. We've lost that.
Fair. We've already lost that sponsor. Yeah.
We lost our music. We lost our sponsors. I mean, I don't know what to say.
We lost our dignity, everything. You know, we have nothing to live for.
I don't know about me.
But yeah, at least we still have some trivia. Am I right?
Yeah.
Three Whoa. Rounds of trivia coming your way in Real yeah. Trivia Face-Off. Whoa. And let's jump into round number one if you guys are ready.
Well, I guess I couldn't develop the script this week. Okay, that's fine.
Now this is pod racing.
All right, let's jump to round number one. Jacob, why don't you take it away with the rules?
Okay, round one, official rules. Here we go. There's going to be 8 questions in random categories given to all competitors. Competitors have 15 seconds to write their answers. Answers must be said aloud when revealing the responses. All questions are worth 1 point, but then a perfect round triggers a 1 point bonus question. Each competitor has 3 repeats that they can ask throughout the match. And they also have 1 challenge. They can challenge any ruling. And then if the ruling gets reversed, then they get to keep their challenge. So, yeah, those are the rules for round one.
All right. So let's just go ahead and start it. I'll read the first question here in round one. You guys are ready to go?
Yep. Yeah, sure.
Okay. So the first question in round one is in the category of action/adventure. And your question is, in Jumanji, Welcome to the Jungle, who plays Ruby Roundhouse, the avatar of Martha within the Jumanji game? Do you play video games, Jacob?
I am what they call a gamer, yeah. I've never played Jumanji, though. I've not played Jumanji.
Jumanji played you? Question mark? 5.
Yes.
4. Gotcha. 3.
You both got played.
1. We'll start with Aidan.
Kieran Gillen.
Okay. Cole.
I put Karen Gillen. We're going to see what happens here.
I honestly didn't remember how to spell her first name. I thought there was something weird about it. Is it just Karen?
I am going to go ahead and say no to both of you.
Okay.
Wait, to Cole?
Cole, you already erased probably, right?
No. Nope. Karen Gillen.
Yeah, he wrote Karen Gillian.
I don't know how else he would
it's,
write.
It's Karen Gillen, G-I-L-L-A-N.
Mm.
Oh. All right.
So I am gonna lean towards no. Just
I hope we don't get a Famke Jensen.
If it change how it phonetically sounds, we usually leans towards ruling against it. If it's phonetically similar, like if you put G I L L E N, we will give it to you because phonetically is the same. But the Gillian.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, so that's fair.
I'm gonna make the hard call and not gonna award you the point there.
No points awarded in the budget. I get it. That's fine.
Yeah, there you go. No score change. We continue at 0-0 to question two.
Okay, yeah. Question two is gonna be in the category of comic book movies. Your question is, what is the occupation of Dick Tracy in Dick Tracy?
Did you know?
Comic book movie I would expect, but
oh, fair.
Yeah, okay. 5, 4,
like Madonna, that's it.
3, 2, 1. Okay, we're going to start with Cole.
A detective.
Okay, and Aidan?
I didn't know. Journalist.
Correct answer. What is police/detective? So one all point right. for Cole.
First lead of the game.
He's a copper.
Yeah. As we go to the third question in the category of dramas. In the musical drama All That Jazz, who plays theater director and choreographer Joe Gideon? I feel like Gideon is a cool last name.
Yeah, it reminds me of, I don't know if you've seen it, but Gravity Falls, you know? There's a character in the name Gideon.
Weirdly, when I hear the name Gideon, I think of the Arrowverse because of the Flash and CN.
I've never seen anything from that.
4, 3.
You think of the computer? 2. Computer voice.
1. Yeah, I think of the computer voice. Hands down. I grew up with that show. Let's go to Ian.
I don't know. Jamie Foxx.
Okay, Cole.
Roy Schneider.
Roy Schneider is correct. So Cole getting another point right there.
I blanked on that name for a second. That was really weird. I was like, dude from Jaws, what's his fucking name?
I don't know what this movie is.
It's Bob Fosse, man. Come on. All the jazz.
Jazz.
Okay, All the Jazz. We're going to move on to question number 4 in the category of fantasy sci-fi. Question is, who directed 2009's The Lovely Bones?
Cole's going to sweep this one.
Bones do be lovely, I guess. I don't know.
I'll give you a hint, Aiden, but I'm not going to.
I have no
time.
No
sorry,
here.
Oh, I forgot the countdown. Anyway, we're gonna start with Cole.
Oh, it's time. Okay, thanks, Jacob.
Yeah. Sorry about
Peter
that.
Peter Jackson.
Peter Jackson. Okay. And Aiden.
I said Robert Zemeckis.
Cole, once again, getting the point for Peter Jackson.
Between Happy Feet and fucking Hobbit movies, he has to make shitty movies, I guess.
Happy Feet.
Those are both.
Happy Feet's good. That's what I said. Between Happy Feet and Hobbit movies.
I think I'm thinking of the wrong director, but okay. All right, let's move on. Let's move on to the fifth question. Talking about Happy Feet, let's go to the realm of animated films, animation. And here is your question. What kind of animal is Billy Joel's character Dodger in Oliver and Company? I like Billy Joel.
I like Billy Joel too. For some reason, I know it's gonna anger a little people. I used to get him mixed up with Elton John. I don't know why, but I always
got I get him mixed up with Billy Idol.
3.
Oh, that's fair. Another 2. Good one.
1. Pens down. We go to Aiden.
He's a dog.
Cole.
Dog.
Dog is correct. 1 point apiece for both competitors.
As long as you're not getting mixed up with Joel Osteen, I think we're okay. That's all.
Okay. Okay. We're gonna move on to
mine. Okay.
Okay. Question number 6, category of comedy. Which Frank Capra directed comedy is about an author known for his diatribes against marriage, who risks his reputation after he decides to get married himself? Is that how you say that word? Diatribes.
I believe so.
Okay.
I've never said it out loud. I've seen it written.
Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 Okay, we're gonna start with Cole.
Oh, I have no idea. I just wrote "It's a Bad Life" as a pun on "It's a Wonderful Life."
Okay, and Aidan.
I don't know. Company.
Okay, the answer we had was arsenic and old lace.
Oh, that is Frank Capra. You're right. Mm-hmm. Oh, Cary Grant.
Great game for me so far.
It's all right. No points for both competitors there as we go to the penultimate question in a category of disaster movies. Disaster movies. And here's your question. Halle Berry and Patrick Wilson's characters work for what organization in Moonfall?
Now, see, this was a good movie to watch in IMAX. It was a really great time. Me and Sam had a blast. I actually enjoyed this movie, not going to lie.
5, 4 I haven't seen it. 3, 2 Not looking forward to it. 1 Pants down as a thumbs down also appear on screen. Let's go to Aidan.
I don't know. The World Health Organization.
Jay and Cole?
For NASA, I have no idea.
NASA is correct. So Cole getting another point there.
Yo, Jacob, you got really long arms.
I'm not going to lie. That scared me. That happened. That just appeared in front of
you. You got scared by your own arm?
No, that was not mine. I have no sleep.
According to Colin, Moonfall coming in October.
Guys. I'm being honest. Best Buy has a good steelbook of Moonfall. Okay, I'll move on. Last question. Your final question. Category of round one. Round one. Category of horror thriller. Your question is: which 1980s horror film features supporting performances from Ellen Green, Steve Martin, John Candy, and Bill Murray?
Yeah.
These are some pretty good supporting performances, I won't lie. Good supporting cast. True. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 Okay, Cole.
Little Shop of Horrors.
Okay, and Aidan.
Oh, yeah, he's right. I didn't have anything.
Little Shop of Horrors is correct.
Okay, so after that round number one, I have a score of Cole with 6 and Aidan with 1. Is that what you have, Jacob?
That is what I have, yeah.
Did I get one right? I thought I meant 0.
You got the dog.
Right. Whatever. GG.
Rough round one for Aidan. Cole getting a strong start, but we'll see if he can turn it around in round two. Yep. Thoughts so far, Jacob?
I think Cole had a pretty strong round one, but you know, Aidan I think has his hopes down a little bit, but you know, we still have 2 more rounds to go. We're gonna see what happens. And yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not out of the game yet.
For sure. All right, as we go on to round number two, let me find the rules right here. So yeah, in round number two, you get to spin the category wheel. If you don't like the initial category that you land on, you get to respin it once unless your initial spin lands on opponent's choice. 5 questions from that category. Each questions are worth 2 points apiece. If you need multiple choice, that is available. However, they will reduce your point value to 1. And if you have an incorrect answer, your opponent may steal, so be careful with that. And both competitors still have all 3 repeats and 1 challenge each. Any questions? Okay, so as we bring today's wheel, here are the categories. We got Star Wars, rom-com, 2000s, Catherine Bigelow, Studio Ghibli, Eddie Murphy, 2010s, Planet of the Apes, and Spinners and Opponent's Choice. Cole, you are in the lead, so what would you like to do?
I hate this wheel. Oh, that's a great question. What do I want to do? I don't know. Technically speaking, I'll spin.
Okay, first spin for Cole underway. Planet of the Apes.
No. Shit.
You gonna see the wheel again?
Yeah, maybe. Fuck. Well, this could go a lot of ways if I spin again. I just think it's almost guaranteed the steals.
Yeah, I will steal every single
one. Yeah, I know. But, you know, Aidan, I have watched them, to be clear. So it's not like people who have.
Go for it then. Do it.
Nah, let's spin again.
Spinning again. Let's see if that spinning again pays off. Here it is. Rom-coms.
I'll probably be okay. Yeah, let's do it. I'm sorry. Okay. I know I don't get a choice, but I want to confirm that I'm going to do it. I know. Big difference.
Thanks for confirming.
That was one of the ones I did not want, so thank you for taking it.
I mean, you're going to regret that because I'm pretty decent, I think.
Okay.
Let's, I don't know.
Okay. Jacob, do you want me to read this or do you want me to?
I could take these.
Why don't you ever ask us who we want to read?
Okay, fine. Yeah. You can pick. Right. Who do you want? Who do you want to read?
Well, not you, Albert, with that attitude. Okay, go ahead.
All right, Jacob. Awesome. Go ahead and read it.
Okay. Cole, are you ready for your first question in the category of rom-com?
Mm-hmm. I better get no flubs, Jacob. Just saying, because I picked you now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. No promises.
Mm.
Okay, your first question is, in Last Christmas, what kind of bird poops on Emilia Clarke's face when she first meets Henry Golding?
A pigeon? Final answer?
That is incorrect. Aidan for the 2-point steal.
Oh my goodness. A parrot, final answer.
That is also incorrect. We were looking for a falcon.
Oh, I don't remember that at all. That's so funny.
Yeah, very strange bird, but you know, all birds poop, I think. So yeah.
Scientifically proven.
Is the partridge in the pear tree? Is that a bird? Is a partridge a bird or is that something else? I almost said that because of Christmas.
I don't know, Cole, but I definitely, according to Albert, can confirm it does poop. So
okay.
Moving on to question number two. Which Oscar-winning actress plays Maggie Murdoch opposite Jake Gyllenhaal in Love and Other Drugs?
Anne Hathaway, final answer?
That is correct for 2 points.
I got that mixed up in my No Strings Attached and my Friends with Benefits. It all got scrambled in my brain there.
Yeah. Okay, now we're going to move on to question number three. Which 2006... romantic comedy is about high school students Neil and Woody, who are sworn enemies that swap bodies as they try to ruin each other's lives, only to fall for each other in the process.
2006. I'm okay. Give me multiple choice, please.
Okay, your multiple choice options are A, The Swap, B, Freaky Friday, C, The Hot Chick, D, It's a Boy Girl Thing. Gonna need an answer in 5.
I'm just gonna 4. Go A, an answer.
That is incorrect. Aidan for the 1-point steal. Is it A, The Swap, B, Freaky Friday, C, The Hot Chick, or D, It's a Boy Girl Thing?
I haven't heard of most of these movies, so let's go D.
That is correct for 1 point.
That's cool. That was another option.
Okay, Cole, your fourth question, category of rom-com. Who played as Rachel Jensen, a receptionist for the Hawaiian resort Turtle Bay, who Peter forms a relationship with in Forgetting Sarah Marshall?
Mila Kunis, final answer.
That is correct for another 2 points. Okay, and your final question. In 2014's Blended, Jim and Lauren both went on a vacation to which African country?
Oh, I knew it. Aiden's got like 50 to pick from out if I don't go with full choice. I think it's Kenya, final answer.
That is incorrect for the 2-point steal, Aiden.
Nigeria, final answer.
That is also incorrect. We were looking for South Africa.
Ah, see, it's so basic. I thought it wouldn't be it. Damn.
Fair. The most tourist field, maybe, of the African country. I don't know. Yeah. That's just a guess. but yeah, so after that round, Cole managed to tally up 4 points, bring up his score to 10. Aidan got the one steal, narrowing the lead there. And now we got the chance to go to Aiden's spin.
This can be...
Are you ready, Aidan?
Yep.
Okay, so here's your first spin. Two thousands.
I'll spin again.
Okay, spinning again. You have to take whatever this lands on.
All right.
2000s it is.
At least you don't have to answer about root soup or whatever the fuck it was.
Root leaf.
Root leaf soup.
All right. So here's your questions in the category of 2000s. Are you ready, Aidan?
Yep.
Okay. Question one. In Holes, Dual Hills character Sam sells what kind of vegetable?
Onions, final answer.
That is correct for 2 points. Question two. What kind of factory does Charlie's father work at in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory?
Oh, this is the Johnny Depp one I haven't seen. Multiple choice.
Okay. A, a toothpaste factory. B, a bicycle factory. C, an automobile factory. D, a chocolate factory.
Let's go with bicycles.
That is incorrect. Call for the 1 point steal opportunity.
Toothpaste, final answer.
Okay, not letting me finish, but getting the steals right for 1 point.
Sorry, I just remember how stupid that scene is because he loses his job because of a robot taking, because they screw the caps on, and that's how he loses his job.
That says a lot about society, though.
Yeah, it's also ridiculous.
Okay, as we move on to your third question, Aidan. Who directed The Fountain?
I've never heard of this movie, so multiple choice.
Okay. A, Terrence Malick. B, Alex Garland. C, Denis Villeneuve. D, Darren Aronofsky.
Well, out of those, it's got to be Terrence Malick.
That is incorrect. Really? Call for the 1 point steal opportunity.
Aronofsky, final answer.
Yeah.
That is correct.
That's the only other one it could have been, I guess. But I thought I knew most of Aronofsky's movies.
That's the one with Hugh Jackman, I think, right? This one's also really depressing. They're all depressing.
So. They're all depressing, yeah. That's all he makes.
He made Mother, which is fucking crazy. So
all right, Aidan. Your next question. Ewan McGregor, William Fichtner, Tom Sizemore, and Josh Hartnett all co-star in what 2000s war film?
Black Hawk Down.
Okay.
Correct for 2 points. And your last question. In Yes Men, Carl and Allison attend a party hosted by Norman that is themed after what movie franchise?
Multiple choice.
Okay. A, Star Wars. B, Marvel. C, Harry Potter. D, Lord of the Rings.
Let's do Lord of the Rings.
That is incorrect. Call for the 1 point steal opportunity.
Harry Potter, please.
Harry Potter is correct for another 1 point steal there.
Oh, is it a so, cape?
no, currently the score is Cole with 13, Aidan with 6, a 7 point differential. Cole did maximize on his steal opportunities there for each of Aiden's miss. But yeah, Jacob, what do you think so far?
Yeah, I think Cole did he did pretty well with rom-com. I think getting points from that, and I think
Both of them got 4 points each in their respective rounds. Cole just maximized on the steals more than Aidan did.
I think for what they were given, I think they both navigated pretty well and got as much points as they get. Aidan with a couple, steals from Cole's category, so I think that helped him out a little bit.
I didn't get any steals.
You got one.
Yeah. Did I? Oh, I don't remember.
What was it? I remember now.
It's a boy girl thing.
Yeah. Oh, right. The random guess one.
But yeah, now we go to the third and final round of this match. How does it go, Jacob?
I'll tell you how it goes. So in round three, competitors will pick four numbers that will correspond to four random categories. Each competitor gets four questions, and they're going to rank their questions to be with 1, 2, 3, and 4 points. There's no stealing or multiple choice this round, but competitors still do have their three repeats apiece, and both still have their challenges.
All right, are you guys okay?
I didn't do that. Who the fuck did that? Aiden, was that you, really?
No.
I didn't do that. Who the fuck did that?
Didn't it say Colin?
No. Who made the sound?
What sound? I don't know. Okay. Yeah, are you guys good?
I guess so. Cole's hearing right. things, but...
No, don't you start this, Aiden.
All right, so yeah, Cole, why don't you go ahead and give us your categories first? Your numbers first.
I'll give my categories, and then you can just tell me the numbers.
We'll go with the numbers.
We can't afford that in the budget. Come on. All right. I'm going to go with 2, 6, 9. Nice. And 13.
2, 6, 9, 13. Okay, Aiden? 7, 12, 14, 15. 7, 12, 14, 15, you said?
Yep.
Okay. So, yeah, Jacob, you'll be reading for Aiden in this round, and I'll be reading for Cole. So why don't you reveal Aiden's categories first?
Okay, Aiden? You pick 7, which corresponds to Studio Ghibli. Cool. You picked 12, which corresponds to 80s.
Cool.
You picked 14, which corresponds to Westerns. Mm. And 15, which corresponds to Jackie Chan.
Cool. GG.
All right. And Cole, you picked 2. That is the category of Tom Hanks. Star of Disney Pinocchio. You pick 6. That is a category of 2000s.
Okay.
You pick 9. That is a category of Planet of the Apes. And you pick 13. That is a category of James Bond. James Bond. So we'll let you guys decide it. But yeah.
I'm ready.
I'm not. Hold on. Wait a second.
I think it's a category. Oh, can you imagine?
Oh god. Okay, hold on, give me 1 second here. I do need a hot second.
Yeah, you got time. Aiden needs a 7-point differential, so he needs his 3 and his 4 at least to tie it. I don't think he seems happy with his category, but we'll see.
Nope.
We've seen crazier stuff happen. But yeah.
Yeah, Aiden, did you say you were ready to say your placement? Okay. Yep. Go ahead.
1 at Ghibli, 2 at Jackie Chan, 3 Westerns, 4 80s.
Okay.
Hold on, not me. I'm not gonna change it. I'm not that okay. I'm ready if you are.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, I'm sticking with my guns here. 1 at Bond, 2 at Planet of the Apes. I'm pretty sure on that one. 3 on 2000s, 4 at Tom Hanks.
Okay. So, yeah, we'll start with Aiden first. So, Jacob, go ahead with the Ghibli one.
Got the same.
Okay.
It's 1 right here.
Yep.
Okay. So, okay. Okay, Aiden, are you ready?
I guess so.
Okay. I don't know how to say that first name, but I'm gonna go
with. Do you want me to say? I can just say the. Well, it's.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I can just read the question then.
Okay. Okay. That might be good.
Okay. Okay. So Aiden, 4-1 point. Seita and Setsuko, two siblings struggling to survive both malnutrition and the firebombing of Kobe, Japan, are the central characters of which Studio Ghibli film?
Grave of the Fireflies.
That is correct for 1 point.
We love depressing Ghibli movies. Woo! Real ranks number one Ghibli movie.
That is.
Or wait, I think so. I can't remember. Matthew, maybe tell me. I can't remember.
Okay.
Go ahead, Jacob.
Okay, yeah, I think I got this one. Okay, in your two-pointer in the category of Jackie Chan.
Mm-hmm.
In The Karate Kid, Jackie Chan's character teaches kung fu to an American played by what actor?
Jaden Smith.
That is correct for 2 points.
Oh. I didn't realize. Okay. I thought it was going to be harder than that. But...
Okay.
Okay.
I like how you're complaining, but sure.
Okay. I just thought there'd be more to the question.
Okay, so
we're not happy about it, but yeah.
We now go to his three-pointer.
Okay, Aiden, are you ready for your three-pointer and westerns?
Yep.
In 2013's The Lone Ranger, what does John end up naming the all-white horse?
Silver.
That is correct for 3 points.
Good pull.
That's just Hayao Silver.
I don't know.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
I've never seen that movie.
So yeah, it's 12 to 13. Aiden mm-hmm. gets the next one. He'll be in the lead. So let's see what happens here.
Okay, Aiden, you're a four-pointer in 80s.
And he does have three repeats if he needs to use it.
Yes, you do have three repeats. What is the name of the chemical substance that kills toons in Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
Man, I've been meaning to rewatch this for a long time. I don't know. I lost
five,
this when I was like 9.
4.
Acme be gone.
Is that your final answer?
Sure.
Be my guess.
Oh, okay. And your winner! By way of technical knockout is Cole the Seltzer Sanders.
Yep. What was the correct answer, Jacob? The
correct answer we were looking for was dip.
Dip. D-I-P.
Okay.
Dip.
Just dip?
Yep.
Like tobacco dip?
I've never heard of tobacco dip, but yeah, just dip.
Really?
So, okay.
But yeah, so yeah, great match. We'll put this competitor backstage. Jacob, thoughts on the match?
So I think Cole got a good lead in round one. I think that really, once that happened, I think that sort of just propelled him to the win. I think Aiden got a little sort of down after that. So I think, you know, it was hard for him to really bring his spirits back up after that. So I think that sort of hurt him later on in the match. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I think with, you know, he got some really good pulls in round three. I think even though he was given categories I don't really think he wanted, he was able to get some good points there. So yeah, he about was able to get all of clean sweep in round three. So I think I can really commend him for that.
Yeah, no, that was really close. I mean, maybe any other movie you could have gotten to four. I mean, he was getting the 1, 2, and 3 right off the bat in all of those questions. Yes, the Who Framed Roger Rabbit one. Don't know if he had to use a repeat. Maybe he could have like randomly pulled it out of nowhere. But also, like you said, yeah, the gap after round one was probably like affecting him a little bit. And it was a 10-point game going to his spin. And I am betting, and we can probably find out in the post game. I'm betting he's probably hoping to get like something like Star Wars. And if he sweep that, that's a tie game. So you know, but yeah, that 2000s probably like he wasn't the biggest fan of. So yeah. Let's just find out and talk to him then right now in the post-game interview, starting with Aiden. So, Aiden, unfortunately unable to go your way today, but how are you feeling?
I don't know. It's one of those things where, like, this isn't even a match I could have possibly studied for because I'd never heard of, like, any of these movies, and they weren't in categories that are easy to study for. Like 2000s and rom-coms and all those other things are just so broad that. Like, there's hundreds of movies there. So I don't feel like I could have really prepared for this match. And I don't feel particularly bad about getting the questions wrong, besides the Jumanji one, because I just didn't know how to spell her name. But yeah, everything else, hadn't heard of, never seen, not really any possible way I could have gotten them. So, oh well. Goes that way sometimes.
That's fair. But yeah, I mean, you still pull off a hell of a fight, in, especially in that round three. That was real close. Do you think, and you did give the answer right away, but do you think if, like, use multiple repeats, you would somehow be able to pull Dip out of somewhere? No.
I saw Who Framed Roger Rabbit when I was 8. I don't remember anything about that movie.
Fair. It is. It's a hefty film. It's interesting. Mm-hmm. 8 years old, I feel like it's pretty young for that film. I don't know why, but yeah.
Yeah. I didn't get most of it.
Fair. But yeah, unfortunately, with today's loss, that means you won't be playing in singles again for a while. Yeah. Does this shift your focus to teams at all, or?
I mean, I'll be excited to play in teams with Andrew again, but I'm not sure how much anything will be shifted.
Fair. I'm pretty sure Andrew is excited to be back in teams with you again too.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, back to singles in the future. Anyone you want to play your next match in the future?
Well, I think one of the only people I haven't played one-on-one yet is Rachel. So I was kind of hoping to win this match so I could go on to play her there, but oh well, some other day, I guess.
Okay, Rachel, we'll definitely keep a note of that and possibly make that happen in the future. But yeah, thank you, Aidan.
Yep, and thank you.
We'll talk to you again soon.
Yep, thanks for hosting. Thanks for writing.
Absolutely. All right, and now we bring today's winner by technical knockout, Mr. Seltzer himself. Let's find out if he finishes Seltzer during the match or he still has some left over. Cole, how are you, sir?
We still got a little bit. I got through the match. Maybe that's what it was. I was trying to get through a match without going two. I've gone two seltzers before in a match. Not good
in a match?
For the stomach. Yeah.
Whoa. Okay.
Not good for the stomach. No.
Fair.
Yeah. So I'm glad I did stick with the one here. Plus, it was my last one. So. Anywho. Yeah. Are you gonna ask me some questions or something?
No, I think
we ran out of budget for that.
We ran out of the budget for the questions. That's fine. No. I'll come with my own questions. All right.
So I'll
ask my own questions.
Okay, go ahead.
Cole, how'd you do round one? Oh, I think I did great. Yeah, I think that turned out pretty well. Don't laugh too hard. You're over your cold tea. Listen.
It's not cold tea.
It's not tea at all. So anyways, I think ultimately Yeah, like Aidan said, there's not much you can do to prepare for some of those. It's really tough. And even I had to kind of jump some hoops to remember some of that stuff. Mostly stupid things like the Roy Schneider thing. Probably could have pulled that quickly if I had, just down in the brain or something. I do kind of wish I did better in round two. Because although I've done decently okay with rom-coms in the past. So it's a little frustrating. But honestly, like, I just kind of had to play it because I knew if I went playing the ape, he was just going to nab those steals, which would have evened the playing field a little too much for my liking, especially with the state of round one. But still, I mean, I could have done playing the apes. I've been meaning to, if I was just really like, if you had asked me like a month ago when I first watched these movies, I probably would have just gone for it because I wanted to answer those questions. Mm-hmm. But I couldn't today. I just couldn't do that to myself.
I mean, like I said, you're worried for the steals because like Aidan knows it. So that's
it's also been a hot second since I've seen the reboot ones, so it's probably not like the best environment because it's probably half and half, or maybe I don't know. Plus, I hate that Tim Burton one, so we don't want to talk about that. But overall, I was happy-ish with round two.
Do you think for round three, if Aiden wouldn't have got his 4-pointer, do you think with your categories you would have been able to?
See, that was tough because I was thinking of that as he was revealing his, and I didn't want to change. I don't know if we have rulings on that, but I didn't want to change it after I wrote it down. I was like, I locked it in here. I probably could have because I don't care. I mean, I had bought. Did I say the numbers? Did I?
You gave. I did. Bond, I did. Yeah. You gave bond bond, at
so,
two.
Bond 1,
no, Bond 1, 2, Apes 2, yeah.
2003, Tom Hanks 4. That yeah. Tom Hanks 4 was just in case I had to, I don't know. Tom Hanks 4 was basically assuming that I'd be okay and like just get the first couple. But I had to put Bond at 1. There was really no shot otherwise. Luckily, it didn't come into play, thankfully. But yeah, I don't know. Sometimes, you know, sometimes the matches that aren't as like, as neck and neck can be a little frustrating for the other person. So I feel for you, Aidan. But as the guy on the other side, it was nice to not have to win my opening singles to Sophie again. I did that twice, right? It was for both tournaments.
Last tournament, yes.
Last tournament and the tournament before that.
The 2020 tournament.
I think so.
2020 tournament.
I know I beat her twice singles for some reason. I don't know why it happened that case.
Oh, first time you played Andrew, so that wasn't
okay. I don't know.
But you probably played her prior or afterwards. Yeah. I don't remember.
Anywho, but oh god, I've been meaning to play Aidan for a long time, and so that was definitely that was much worth it. I guess I do have a question because I can't remember in the town hall if you mentioned how it's seated now. Will I go on to play Rachel? I can't remember.
Admin database. Rachel. Yes. If
Woo!
If you win your next match. Oh. Okay, so Rachel is in two matches down. Okay, so you win your next match, you'll be playing Rachel. So do you want to know who you're playing next?
I do want to know who I'm playing next.
You're gonna be playing the winner of Jacob versus Sam.
So, oh shit. Okay.
Any thoughts on that? Next matchup.
Yeah. You have both of us right here. You can talk all your smack.
I can't wait to play you, Sam.
Okay.
He said he I just got what you said. What the heck?
Sam cannot hear. So I don't think Sam can hear you.
I can't wait to go against you, Rach. I love you.
Okay. So yeah, that is a preview of what possibly might come here in the next few days. We'll have to see.
By the way, to be clear, I'd be happy to play either of them. I'm actually really excited either way. So, everybody, yeah, I bet Cole. Jacob, yeah, Sam, I bet. Or Rage would be great. So, I think it's a win all around.
Fair. But yeah, so we'll see you again soon in that next singles matchup. And then in the near future, we'll also be seeing you back in teams. So yeah, looking forward to all of that.
Cool. Looking forward to that.
So thank you. Thank you, Cole. And we'll see you again next time.
Cheers. Good night.
Finish your seltzer. Bye. Let's see if you can finish it. Mm-hmm. Nope, he did. Okay, nice. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, no, you didn't finish it. You spilled all over the place.
Last minute quick like spill finished. Right before.
Well, can't believe he tried to trick us. But yeah, Jacob, now that Cole's not here, you want to trash talk to him a little bit? No?
No, I'm going to give a quick shout out to Sam. You know, whatever happens in that match, I'm happy whatever way it goes. But yeah, I'm ready to beat Cole in a match. And then, I'm really excited about that. And then
Cole has beat me once, and I'm going to beat him this time. Wait,
so if I beat Sam and then I beat Cole, then I get to go up against Rachel again?
Yes.
Is
that the third time in 1 year you against Rachel?
Too bad you won't beat me.
I think
that's insane if that's the case.
I think that would be our third time. Shit. I want
in a year.
Best two out of three. Best two out of three. I want a rematch, and I want to. Yeah, I want to win. So, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but you're gonna be done with singles for a while after our match.
No, that's not true. Mm-hmm. That's not true.
Mm-hmm. I'm coming for you, Rach. I love you, and I want to go against you.
So yeah,
it's not gonna happen. So you don't have to worry about it, Rachel.
That's a preview of what's
to come. Doesn't
want
to go against you again. She doesn't like you.
Jacob and Sam teasing ahead. Jacob and Sam is actually playing on the 28th at 8 p.m. Eastern. So tune into that one.
Everybody watch it. My mom's going to be watching it. Everybody should go ahead, watch it. We're going to have a huge watch party. Not me, because I'm going to be in the match. But yeah.
Fair.
Everybody watch it.
That should be a lot of fun. But yeah, thank you everyone for watching this one. If you stick around till the very end to see all this promo stuff happening right now, this teaser. But yeah, thank you everyone for watching. Thank you, Jacob, for being a lovely guest host here. Thank you to Sam for making a guest appearance. Thank you to Cole. Thank you to Aidan for being great competitors. Thank you everyone in the live chat. And yeah, we will see you again next time. If you're tuning in live, we do have a match again in like 1.5 hours.
Oh shoot, yeah. That's late. Okay.
One and a half hours. We have another match. Me and Matthew, we're playing.
I'm excited for that one. I was really looking forward to it on Monday. Was it Sunday? Monday, I think it was. Monday. But yeah, but you know, I guess it could not have happened. But
yeah.
You know,
it's happening tonight though. So
yeah, I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. So yeah.
Yeah, should be a lot of fun. Matthew's going down, but yeah. thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you all next time. Bye bye.